some Costello on Sanders and BT Center. Karen, do I have that on HMD?
Jennifer Wilson, manager of the cabin and lights.
Drew Mohan, operations manager for the bid.
Ruben, Gary Stevens.
Steve Litton, executive director.
Karen Costello, Red Studios, and Home Chair. Okay. Well, let's move right to the group of ordinance. And we have a chance to come up with a new one.
Yeah, we see, we got three or four people.
Just got an introduction. Do you introduce yourselves, please?
Just in time.
Oh, I'm sorry. The three of us. Brian Stane with Palin. Sorry.
Can you talk me out?
I'm Ron Brooks. Who am I introducing myself to?
Just now.
Oh, well, yeah.
We have to go with comments.
We have a meeting after our presentation. So I just want to do that,
Okay. Sweet presentation. Okay. What time do you need to leave?
We can move that. Yes, I'm the only one.
Okay. All right. Well, if time starts getting coming, just let me know. We'll move you up. Anybody like to offer a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Any question? Abstained? Truly noted.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, let's move on to the treasurer's report.
Thank you. UPS update. We have made progress in our work on evaluating the documents. As soon as we get that done, I'll be able to present a full report to the board, hopefully at the April meeting. It's taken over 50 hours, my hours already, so we're getting it. CPA recommendation. I would like to recommend the hiring of a CPA for our bid. I need a motion from the board. We currently are paying our treasurer, our CPA, $3,100 just to file our taxes. And we need to get our QuickBooks aligned with the city's chart of accounts. And we also need to file our financial statement with the city on May 1st every year. So I would like to recommend to the board, I guess I can make a motion as the treasurer, that we engage the firm of GTL. LLPs
Any questions?
Will their prices comparable?
Less.
It appears that we'll be getting more services for
less
for a lower price. So, any other questions? Any questions?
Could I have clarification on the motion as to
the motion? The motion is to hire the firm of GTL LLP certified public accountants. Thank you.
Any questions? Any comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
treasurer's report. Some of you may be aware that Mayor Garcetti is responsible for an increase in the minimum wage. I'm not asking the board to make a decision on how we feel about the minimum wage. What I'm doing is letting you know that should it pass, our budget will change in terms of EPS, and I think probably in the HMT, because the minimum wage will go from 9 to 13.75, and in terms of EPS, I met with them, all of the ranks will increase by the same amount. So I'm just letting them, just making you aware that we'll keep you posted. Committee is still taking testimony through next Tuesday, then it will go to council, and I think we have time by our April meeting if the board wanted to make a position on minimum wage and then be able to testify at council. And then lastly, some of you may recall, I have been trying to get our money from the state for 3 or 4 years. Well, in 2014, former Assembly Speaker Perez passed legislation which the governor signed, and it's AB 2618. And that requires the state to pay the bids in which they have property as long as you can make a case for special treatment, meaning that whatever you did for the state on their property was above and beyond what would generally be done by the city of Los Angeles. So we can't make that case. I am now writing a report to document in every for every year and for which bills all the special services the state received, and they have.
Beach Rock.
Pardon me?
Beach Rock, the state has.
They have DMV, coal. We have a couple of good properties, Springfield and Target. This doesn't apply to feds who have social security, which they aren't paying for, but it does, but it is a big chunk of change. And there's still a dispute on 1 year where the state did pay and the city somehow didn't pay us, and so I'm working to get that one today. So that's my update.
Question with regards to minimum wage. Do we know what the wage levels are for the current staff in UPS and the related to?
Yes. Well, for UPS, we do. You're asking what the outlets are? Oh, I just got that. I'm sorry. I thought you said, do we know what they are? Yeah, we do. And you what?
Well, we know what we pay.
No, yeah. You're asking what we're paying now?
Right.
Yes, we do have that. Now, what they're going to be increased to will be the percentage in the jump in the minimum wage. So it's going from $9 to $13.75. That percentage, that delta, is what they will all be raised at. So, Stephen, can you just review the hourly cost?
Sure. I can tell you that I received information to you part of the summary plan, management plan. And within that, the line items are listed there. Do you want to go over them now?
I was just wondering. Say the UPS staff are already being paid minimum wage, or maybe they're already above the levels which minimum wage would be.
Some aren't. Some aren't. But in fact, UPS is what we've already met with them. They are increasing by the delta, so well, it doesn't matter. But they have people making minimum wage of $9 an hour, and some making more. Do you still want to know what each level is?
Right. I think it would be useful for everybody to know if we're carrying the conversation, to the extent that we need to carry the conversation forward with regards to the city.
Well, if we go through the presentation, UPS tells us the changes in the city. I don't have the changes.
And I can go over the numbers with you right at the beginning if you want. Do you guys want to know what's our weekly cost is? Okay, so our weekly cost for security.
The rank
varies by.
I
don't have that rank.
You have other restrictions. I can do it.
Are you sure?
I'm a restriction for you for our review.
It's listed right here.
So you have how many points to go? We can also be also cities.
Okay. No, I'm not going to. Okay, so, our regular guard makes $17.63 an hour, a corporal makes $19.35, a sergeant makes $19.75, a lieutenant makes $21.51, a captain makes $28.22. That's just on our last billing.
Is that what we're billed or what UPS pays?
This is what we're billed.
Right, so they actually don't get paid as much as you quoted, because there has to be some administrative work in the UPS.
I assume there is.
Right, so my point is that they're not paying.
Oh, yeah, that's
the number that you just quoted is what you're making something else.
Right, but this is all, I understand that the information.
This is all we as a customer, this is all we as a customer get.
That is correct, I can get UPS to tell us what they're paying.
Because what you're interested in is
anybody.
If anyone's actually paying the minimum wage.
Yes, there are, that we do know.
I mean, or really, if it's raised to $13.75, I mean, it's actually made under that an hour. Otherwise, it shouldn't affect us at all.
Well, it is because they're raising their hourly fees based on the fact that there's an increase in the minimum wage. They're raising everything. That's UPS's position. We met with them already in anticipation of this, so I could work on our budget and figure out what we would be paying. And the delta is what that percentage is what they are raising their hourly rates to bill us.
So, Lori, it's not just that the minimum wage is increased, the budgetary impact is that all hourly wages are increased in the same proportion.
Correct.
So, that's what you need to do is once you do that, then it's not what is each one, what's the total budget.
Correct. Right. Exactly right.
So, what would happen then?
First of all, it hasn't passed council yet.
But it's probably
going to. It probably is going to. I'm working with UPS now on.
It's about a 15% hit, isn't it?
Something like that. They thought it might be a little less. I met with Jay and I met a couple of weeks ago. So, we're waiting to see what their plan is. They're going to send me a list. So I'll be back to you on that. I just wanted to mention that. Great. Any other questions, comments? Thank you, Lori.
Very confidential person.
So the next line item number seven, the internal machine.
And more on the zero defense.
Okay. So as was passed at last month's board meeting, to utilize the UCLA urban planning students to do some kind of cool and interesting things for us along Santa Monica Boulevard and surrounding neighborhoods. There is a request here for up to, doesn't mean we'll spend this much, but up to $3,000 related to their activities, which would be copying supplies, data collection, surveys, visual aids and presentation. So one of the ways I thought we could use these students in kind of more detail about actually who is in the bid, how many people work here, so that can be a part of the plan. So currently we don't have that data. If you look at the other bids website, I like to use South Park as an example. There's really good data up on their website, which is very helpful to business attraction and retention. So this $3,000 would help look at our area, find out what kind of opportunities are available in current trends. Lori mentioned that there is already a plan in place for the CRA until 2025, is that correct?
Yeah,
right. So these students will kind of march to your beat. They will get instructions from you guys before they launch on the project, but it's this will help fund some of their activities that will be related to to what we end up getting from them, which hopefully will be some cool visual aids. Some things that would be useful to the bid as a whole. So I'm asking for $3,000 towards that.
How much more than $3,000? I mean, it's a lot for copies, but I'm just curious how it's going to be monitored and more of an accounting of it. Where did the $3,000 come from?
So we would form, so there are going to be two different studies, about $1,500 each. So we would kind of come up with a scope of work. You guys would come up with a scope of work and kind of send them off. Mm-hmm. And again, it's an approval up to $3,000. It's not, it doesn't mean that that amount of money would be used. Chief, you're calling it.
Is that Reginald? How long does this take? How long does the time frame of the meeting work?
I was told it'd be 9 months, and then they would kind of meet, show you guys what they came up with, and then do a formal presentation.
Did you do an RFP to find them, or did you just decide to get them?
I was approached by somebody who works with you, so we were planning. I brought them aboard last meeting, discussion about it.
Anybody else have any questions, comments?
I assume it's going to be, the students are doing this as part of a project of the school as well, they get that benefit out of it, that it would be considerably less than if we hired an urban planning. That's just the assumption, that's why we didn't put it on the budget.
Or less than the urban planning.
Exactly.
Whatever.
I'm sorry, we're getting in relation.
Right. Well, I have a question. Who's going off to you? Who do you suggest we should do?
We can do it several different ways. We could have a very good three individuals from the board who decided to take that on. So that hasn't been determined yet.
We've talked about.
There'll be a lot of discussion about the framework of this.
Right. Yeah. We're not going to decide now, but we've talked about having a committee for the leadership.
As high for the student groups, because so the group of students, our individual has not accepted our application. So on the application, it's usually a good idea to at least give them some funding in order to carry out the work. Again, for data collection, for copying, for creating visual presentation. You wouldn't want to put it out there and not have any funding available to them if the students have to go to the market. So the purpose of asking for this money is to put into our application, and then we send that out off to UCLA, and then we see if we get any bites back from the plan. This may not be a project we're interested in doing. It may not be a business.
Well, nobody accepted it.
Yeah, nobody has accepted this. We're just putting the proposal together to send out to them.
I want to make a motion that we don't be include $3,000 for this program to relinquish San Antonio Boulevard.
So let me also make this clear too. This is not anything that will affect the relinquishment. But it does look at what relinquishment would look like if we had jurisdiction of it and we could do things.
But what does it look like once you add it and not relinquish it?
That's what I'm saying. So what would relinquishment look like if we had jurisdiction and were able to do these things? They're going to be looking at it from that perspective. See what's presenting possibilities to us. These are things, these are trends, these are, if you guys have this kind of right of way, you can do this or you can do that.
That is scoping. Of what you need.
It has nothing to do with what you're pushing about.
Yes.
Scoping of what you need.
Yes.
Yeah, just the Department of Urban Planning at UCLA. It would be like hiring an urban planner to give us a scope and some direction. We might go, these people will fit.
This is stop at one, but it continues to come.
We're interested in having a look at our area. They're going to consider all the way, I would assume that, I know the discussion, from what I understand, is at least to the freeway. That's part of the discussion that I'm hearing about from various individuals. I don't know if it goes further east than that, but in the part of the conversation that I've been a part has been from the 101 freeway to So we're interested in having them do our area. If Jeff and I want to
have the apartments involved there too, there is apartments.
Yeah, so we're not interested in getting involved in that. We're interested in our area.
So it looks to me as though this is a way to create some visuals that we can show to the stakeholders that we're actively involved with the visual look of the relationship. And if they work in conjunction with the relationship committee, hopefully they'll be able to do this within the guidelines of
CRA's development. I have a question. Why are we talking about the relationship?
Or
In relation to what UCLA is doing, because I've already been working with Captions on the relationship, and this has the planning of what the boulevard looks like after it's removed, which has nothing to do with the language. There's only one thing Caltrans is worried about, and it's their responsibility for repairing the street now, the roadway.
Boy, how do we accomplish the language? Because we would like that, but how possible is that? If it's a pipe dream that can't happen, then it's a waste of money, which is a good contribution to UCLA. I think this is good if it's coupled with advancing the linkage goal, that goal, which is good.
Yeah, it's really more in conjunction with our efforts to further relinquishment, to be able to provide visual something that we can send, that we can put in our newsletter, something that we can show.
But it really has nothing to do with
it. It doesn't have to do with the mechanics of relinquishment. We all
and I can have to get updates on
this. Is just really how the more relinquishment might look like and why we're in it.
So we should have a relinquishment.
Yeah.
Steve, 2 years ago, when Doc sees the vision, I think he may have his visuals, because when he had that scope 2 years ago with Doc Sussman, he did Santa Monica Group. He saw this area of Doc Sussman.
Testament.
Yes, he did the visual on Santa Monica.
That'd be great to know.
I tell you what, I'd like to make the recommendation that we table this and can we all discuss I think it's a great idea to utilize.
What's your idea?
For someone. Let's table this until we can have a discussion with your organization.
Just a couple of things.
four instances have occurred that LAPD had to be involved. One of them, I'm not sure if it's still there, but NBC had to be, was classified as a LAPD detainee. Person that was actually in breaking windows on Highland. Hoping that it wasn't one of your properties, but it was one of your walk-ins. And we just observed, and the LAPD also saw that. But after that, four instances did occur where the suspects were taken mentally ill people, practically. So there were actually dismissed. And like I said, that's leasing because sorry for the rush. I'm not sure if everybody's aware, but it was so full right now. Starbucks is open on Willoughby and Highland. All the kids are there. It looks like McDonald's. It's called Starbucks. Every all the kitchen walls goes up. Actually right there, and I had to go around the corner because even the drive was small. So I guess renting that business over there is really, really being used for good purposes.
That's great.
That's actually my report right now.
I've got a million times. I personally would like to commend you for the work that you're doing with all of our citizens, not just those that are stakeholders, those that have homes, but those that have. It says a lot about you, and it says a lot about
good afternoon. I am embarrassed to say that I left the living report on my desk. I promise to bring it next time. So the other half of my report is the greeting report, and on a very happy note, we retain West Coast Arbors for the tree trimming we did, and they will bring out multiple crews and equipment on April 2nd and 3rd. The medians and the palms of the Hoyer and Cole. And they're a wonderful company, and this will be done very professionally. We work closely with Stephen, we work closely with the council office in the city to get your permits paid for. They were over $4,000. You have to be enclosures on Highland. So for 2 days, on that Thursday and Friday, we'll use that lane on either side of the medians. But there's going to be no parking in the parking lane, so no, that's where traffic can flow through. So you only park in 2 days on that. The second and the third is going to take 2 days. There's a lot of
work. Would you be regulating from the mediums? We need to put permits for that?
Yeah.
It's like last week they were working on the right. And they were having to do it.
So as a part of the what we just are spending money on this particular project, the 9,000 for tree trimming.
Yeah,
the trees on your street are going to trim.
Okay. Yeah, but how do you determine?
I have requested of Sharon and Jeff to put together an exact inventory of all of our trees, including the type, and I will go through and put a program together to see what kind of rotation, how frequently we want the trees.
And that's been still in process.
They started on the inventory, and they started on the inventory list, and I haven't received a completed one yet, but I know that they're working on it.
I could have sworn that some trees on Santa Monica on one side were trimmed.
They were trimmed by a billboard. They were butchered by a billboard.
What was trimmed by Steve?
Do we, as Sharon and her Steve, in past years we've also done a little meeting on the planets where the trees are, and I was not sure if that was a special thing or that's part of our budget.
The tree wells are maintained during the watering, and you cut back on the watering program. You have tree wells that are not being, so what we did, we totaled the rotation, we did three rotations last fall when it was in the drought. Mm-hmm. We went back and we weeded everything. We touched all 956 trees. You cut back on how many
many trees you're watering. So only the trees that get watered are having the tree wells maintained in that way. Cleaning crew tries to come in and catch up now, and they don't have a great opportunity to do that. So that was part of the tree program.
Okay. So I'll just point out something maybe you're not going to talk, and necessarily which you wish, but my street there, it was part of the water program, I know it was.
Okay, we'll look into it.
Yeah, you know, and those summer trees look okay, and then springtime, I thought it was summer. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Chair.
So thank you for allowing me the opportunity to describe to you what's happening in the median on Highland. As we were talking about, we have Highland, north of Fountain, we started working on two medians, 2005-2006. We were able to raise enough money to do the design, put them through the process to get permitting, and then we were 90% done, and the CRA was abandoned or dissolved, and there was a redistricting as well. District 13 and District 4, there were a realignment, and the project kind of stopped. So a few months ago, we got the redistricting of the project on between Fountain, between the Longray and the North. Gave us a check for $25,000 because they were supposed to give us that.
That's half a medium, right? Was it $50,000?
That came through
the development
agreement.
Yeah,
that's what
CHNC did.
Yeah,
we're talking about the
class.
No, it's
much
more.
It's much more.
No,
it
was
weak. No, not medium.
It's actually only paid for $1 there.
So
we're meeting at
the
small. So we have the $25,000, and we set up a meeting downtown with the Department of Public Works, CD13, and basically they decided that they want to move this project forward. CD13 has allocated $85,000. CD4, I met with Tom. And Tom has promised, it's not yet confirmed, that his office will do the best to allocate $100,000. And what we are working on is, I just got the files back from Rick Mayer, the organization that did the actual planning, and we're waiting for the notes from the Department of Building and Safety to get everything back from them as the corrections needed. Because for sure there are new requirements now, because all this was done in 2008-2009. And where we are right now is we'd like this board to put us back on your agenda for next meeting, because by next meeting I should have budgeted, like how much is going to cost for the median. We're going to get, because hopefully we'll be able to do them ourselves with cost plus, which would be a very affordable way than going to the city, because we can hire our own contractor and manage that project. So where we are right now is we like this organization, the business improvement is to look at maintaining the median. We're not asking you for money for the median. We are going to be able to raise the money to do the median. We will supervise the construction. Between Jack and I have enough experience in construction. We'll be able to supervise it. So Rick Mayer doesn't have to charge us for that. And so this is where we are. I have no idea how much it costs to do to bring you more detailed information. When we run it by a couple of people that tell us how much it costs to maintain them, and then we get a budgeted item how much it costs to build the median, because most likely we have a couple of bids that are done through the city. One of them is over $400,000, which I think it's ridiculously high. But the contractors would not bid them until they got the information, which was about 2 days. So we sent it to the two contractors that do public works projects, and I talked to them, they're willing to help us doing it cost plus, which would be really good. And then the idea is to do the planting a little bit different than the medians down the street. You want to do drought tolerant, less maintenance, so it doesn't cost us as much for water and maintenance.
Okay.
So that's where we are.
Jack, this is the embarrassing job that both of you did together. Dave Edwards has been calling me on this for the last 2 weeks because the agency worked so closely with the trawler there to get media incentives. The ones you're talking about are north of Fountain, correct? Yeah. And our bid stops at them.
No, there will be a bid extending still.
Extending to the north. To the long way, but not all the way up.
Starbucks is now doing business in the media district. I just went and got coffee beforehand. So please make sure you stop by and support that. I actually only saw two little bike stands there, which kind of surprised me since it's definitely like a little neighborhood stop. So it's probably there's only two little bike stands, but maybe there's more than we could. It was busy. I was really busy.
That's the most important thing, is busy. I'm busy.
Oh,
yeah.
So we talked about building a new website. We have some money in our marketing and improvements budget. It's allocated $42,000. So I'm working with a bid consortium in identifying some sites that I like. One is with South Park, and they just completed their RFP. And they've decided to go with a firm. I'm going to get more information about that. And their proposed budget was $8,000. And the scope of work is pretty comprehensive. So I kind of like to use this as a starting point. And I think that we should use as a starting point to get moving in finding a vendor who can get us a new website and kind of whether it's Hootsuite or whatever we use to get proper social media marketing for our businesses within the bid. I know that Jennifer has been really interested in moving that forward as well. I just would like to say, I think Joseph had mentioned on several occasions about the importance of having a retail committee. I don't care what we call it, I think it's really important that focus on what's needed in the area to make it more attractive to business. I think some of the cool stuff that we can do is public art installations along the highland to kind of promote our galleries that are down on the highland in Santa Monica. There's all sorts of creative things we can be doing. You know, there should be some more crosswalks on the highland. We should be advocating for it to be paved. And by the way, it was mentioned in the conversation that when I was looking to see if what other projects are going on the highland with public works, I think that I saw that there's going to be paving project within the next month.
Sidewalk?
No, paving of a pilot. Paving of pilot. So I don't know what type of resurfacing. I don't know if it's just a slurry. If it's a slurry seal, so it's not going to be that comprehensive, but it'll be an improvement. But we should be advocating for a really good whole reconstruction or something.
Great sidewalk.
Absolutely.
See, how do you and that's important. It would be important for this tribunal to do something. But how do you implement it? How do you get more activity, more improvement on Highland, which, you know, like your business is in the galleries and getting attracted there, and we're getting incredibly people incentives to our property, you know, pretty high end and art and related businesses. So how would we do that? How would we improve the look? Some of the things that you just suggested.
Well, as you know, there's a lot of work. Like when they were talking about the mediums and stuff, there's a lot of meetings, there's a lot of you know, ideas that have to be vetted, and you have to find the proper resources, and then you have to mobilize based on that. So it's too much work for one person, and so I think that type of work needs to be in committee for everybody. So the property owners, first of all, have to kind of talk together, discuss what's important to them, and then determine set some priorities, and then find some funding or find some grants or anything that's that will make those things possible. And then we sit down and we meet with the proper city agencies to kind of get that done. And when you ask in a group and you're very clear about your plan and your ask, it moves quicker.
Why can't we use the ACLA students to do an urban design plan for Highland? There are guidelines. The RA did guidelines for Highland as part of one of their projects 7 years ago. But it sounds to me that the UCLA students could do an urban planning
project.
Yeah, it makes more sense than Santa Monica, just so everyone knows they are not burying the utilities. And that was the point of the urban design teams. They are not buried in the utilities. Not happening.
I didn't ask that as a student group, but I.
I'm just thinking.
I've always wondered.
That just makes more sense.
Yeah.
Santa Monica needs it much more than Highlands.
But there are a couple of plans on Santa Monica, as Jacques and Harris mentioned, assessment plan, a design plan, urban design plan.
I
Anything I sent Monica, I would love to see her break.
I agree.
The same way that Highland can sound, but of course Highland in particular. But I may be naive about how this stuff works because I'm new to this, but my hope would be that if the committee came up with a set of concrete recommendations that could then be presented to the bid board, if the board approved it as the official request of the bid, then that could be put forward to the council members as a very clear advocacy for here's the top three priorities that we think, like crosswalks, for example, that kind of thing. And that would be a really just focused way to say we, business owners and community, this bid feel like these are really needed. The other thing that I had chatted with Steve about, that I think the bid could potentially be useful in is helping to galvanize public-private investment. Because right now, for example, on our block, we've got a lot of side issues, we've got a lot of alley issues. If the bid could somehow help to help organize the property owners to be able to jointly invest, maybe with some co-investment matching funds for the bid and or from the council members, under the auspices of the bid, maybe some project of that could be done with a combination of bid money and private money and maybe council money. Because I know a lot of businesses would be happy to make some of those investments, but don't know how to go about it. It's hard for them to organize independently. I know this is something the city council has been discussing as well as a way to deal with some things like sidewalk repairs.
Right.
There's another thing to consider in the development agreement with the developers who start developing the Highland to get them to pay for sidewalk improvements and other things.
Okay.
Across, I mean, it's happening right now. It's happening in Hollywood. It happens all over the developers. That's how we got $25,000 from Lennar to pay for the Highland Median. We put it in their entitlements. They had to.
Yeah, this is the work of the committee. It's impossible to do all of that on the board level.
Oh, yeah, you can.
That's the work of the committee to do that kind of work and bring it to the board, and it's generally
that.
Which was going to bring up the ambitions. So, back to you.
So, that was my pitch on the retail committee. Once again, we talked about creating something where we welcome new businesses in, and this is a little ways off, but it's just kind of part of like being a well organized, well oiled machine, and I think that we should look at having some sort of welcome basket or some kind of thing that, so that new businesses kind of know who's around. So once we have our directory refined, we obviously have a website which we would offer to kind of promote their business on and their special events. But if you have anything particularly from your business that, you know, any kind of product or whatever, I don't know if you're makes it, but just keep this in mind about anything creative we can do to kind of welcome a new business. If you have an idea or something, please bring it to us.
How about we give that one? How about we give no trespassing signs?
Yeah, we can do that. Thanks to you, we now have them up on the website.
No, you have the forms, but it can only be enforced if you also post the sign. But I had to go buy no trespassing signs to put up.
Sorry, is that crazy?
Because my understanding is UPS cannot actually enforce trespassing unless you post no trespassing signs.
We're totally open to those ideas. Yes.
Would you be initiating this in terms of a welcome packet to, or possibly the gym if Mattress Starbucks, I use that as a current example? I mean, it could be something as simple. I can say what a lot of people don't have, and it's surprising to me. It's one of the reasons I'm part of it. So I have phone numbers of city officials, of sharing it to LABT and John. And all the really important numbers that you need if a tree falls down or if you need to call security or something. Because people don't have it. Okay.
This
this is what I was told Chiba we should do. It's a pan, it's a backpack. Put a map of our bid and all the other important funders on each side. This is what I did with the park. Here's my park, and here's all the facts about the park. Is that great?
Is that expensive?
No.
$1 billion.
$1 billion.
Okay, so I don't want to get locked on that. I just want to put it in your file. I just want to talk a little bit about some casework. So Vince Coding is a new company that opened where the old Time Warner Cable building was. They did a really nice job refurbishing that structure. Also, a company which I believe the name is Litpost. They gave me a tour. And it's a film and television production company. We've been assisting them with some of their issues. Public storage, we had meetings with them. We tried to work with them and took care of some issues regarding keeping the sidewalk clean. There also was an incident, an automobile accident at the corner, northwest corner of Wilcox and Santa Monica Boulevard. A drunk driver hit a light pole, a fire hydrant in one of our metal trash receptacles. You guys know they're quite expensive. So as soon as I got the pictures of the accident, I reached out to Senior Lead Officer Julie Noni. I found out that in fact it was a drunk driver. There is a police report, a police call. They made a report. The gentleman was hospitalized. He was really intoxicated. And it looks like he has insurance. So we're going to go after the insurance company and kind of recoup the cost of replacing that trash can. And if I'm not mistaken, it's around $800 or $1,200. All right, so we're gonna try to recoup the cost on that because it's not going to be able to be refurbished. I want to thank Adam for an excellent tour of this facility. He shared his professional story with me and his experience on the production side of being fresh associates and serving his customer base and turning Kyoto into an industry leader in insurance sector. So, really interesting. I don't know if you guys have been in this facility, but I highly recommend it. It was very interesting. Also, I know some people have been talking about needing help with parking restrictions. So we have a business watch meeting that is hosted by LAPD. Hal Fang of the LAPD is invited to address the group. And he's going to answer your questions about parking restrictions. So please, keep in contact with LAPD and join about that meeting.
What is that name? Business Watch meeting? Will you be in Dallas?
Okay.
What do you mean by Business Watch meeting?
What, third Thursday?
Tuesday, fourth Thursday, April, and tomorrow will be the official announcement. Yeah. It's a meeting that LAPD has to kind of talk about.
No, I just don't know what
you're
talking about.
Tuesday, April 14th.
All right, and I just wanted to kind of circle back on that. We continue to respond to Mr. Riskin's request for public records. So that's moving forward. And stay tuned for our next meeting. We're going to have LA City Council District candidates David Rue and Carolyn Ramsey from the rest of the board if they accept our invitation to come out today. And so that's it. Our next meeting is April 23rd.
So I'd like to continue our new business in encouraging the advocacy business development committees. Any other committees that we feel need to meet in this next month. I would like to encourage the Community Safety Committee to meet specifically to review and to possibly develop RFPs to put both our clean and our safety projects out to bid. It's time to review what's done and to talk to some other contractors about what they have to offer, just so that we can do the right thing by our children. And advocacy and business development, if we can discuss opportunities for business development and business support in their area, possibly the organization that we're using. Anybody else, would anybody else have the same thing with regard to new business?
Yes.
Well, unfortunately, we attended the last meeting, and for the last meeting of the board, your bylaws ad hoc committee was created, or according to Stephen created, and I wasn't there. It was approved. And I know some people that would like to be on it, and I confirm that we will also be on it. So I will be circulating the current bylaws. They review them and then make your changes. We'll have a meeting and put all our changes together and present it.
And please send a notification to both Mike and Lori. You're going to join
the committee. I love to tell you, Mike's on it, Carol's on it, Will's on it, Ron. I hope to see them. Ron.
Yeah.
Ron.
Well, I didn't really talk to that word in policy.
What's in the minutes, I guess. Ron, Will, Carol, Mike, and me. And then, do you want to have a resolution? Me? What is the board? Yes.
What's the board?
Want to talk about resolution?
That's right.
Is anyone in the